Welcome to this episode of Top Knox Fishing Adventures. This is your host, Mark Cooper. On this episode, we find ourselves in Watts Bar Lake, one of the largest lakes in the Southeast. It has 39,000 acres of recreational paradise and some 722 miles of shoreline. Encompassing one of the most biodiverse lakes in the United States, Watts Bar Lake is truly one of the coolest places to fish, and it has so many giant big fish species, it's amazing. To 50-inch plus muskie, giant stripers, and even bigger catfish, Watts Bar Lake truly has it all, and I'm proud to call it my home. So sit back, relax, and come along for the ride as I take two of my friends who are relatively new to fishing out to catch some big catfish.
Oh, he's decent, for sure. Ooh, she got some drag going,
yeah! Well, good afternoon, y'all. This is Mark Cooper of Top Knox Fishing, and it is a blustery and windy November day here in East Tennessee. It's a Sunday, and we are out on Watts Bar Lake here in Kingston, Tennessee, chasing blue catfish, flathead catfish, and maybe stripers. We're gonna be dragging today, or start out dragging, and we're gonna try to find some active fish up shallow in these creeks where all this bait's at. And in the last video you saw where we just had a heck of a time catching huge numbers of fish and we ran out of bait. Well, today we have come and caught a ton of fresh skipjack and big ones too, so we ain't running out of bait. And we are here today with my friends Brett and Chica, and we about to load up on some daggum catfish. Ain't that right, guys? Yee hee! And old pig sled's gonna come out in this windy weather. We're gonna be dragging, and we're gonna catch some big old catfish. It's a little nipply out here! Good afternoon, y'all. We are now moved back into this back creek. We are in 5 feet of water. The water tent's probably 65, 66, something like that. And there's tons and tons of bait fish back in the back of here. And the main channel for the river is out there. And this is a big, deep creek that directly cuts in off that main channel. Like there's a defined little groove that dumps into the main river. So when those catfish become active, they use that creek channel as a highway to move in and out. That's how fish work, all fish. But we're gonna be focusing on catfish today. And what we're going to be doing, we're going to be dragging 6 rods total, 2 straight out the back, just flat lines, and then we're going to put 4 planer boards out, and I will show you how to use that planer board. And this is one of the most fun ways to catch catfish besides bumping, because you'll see that board just ski across the surface when a catfish hits it, and it's like the coolest dang thing ever. And Brett and Chica have yet to experience that yet, so we're going to try to get on some numbers of fish real quick, catch us a few, and then we're going to go try to chase a toad back on the main river channel in some deep structure. We could luck into a big one here, but most of the time you're going to catch your big giant fish out deep. We have a good chance of catching like some 30s, maybe a 40 pounder in here, which would be well over both of their personal bests. So we're going to get at it. This is the type of structure we're fishing. Let's let it zoom out here. Big giant creek off the main channel. Okay, we started out in the back to get our baits out, and now we're just dragging it down this creek channel, trying to stick next to the deeper portion of it, like right through here. We're running 2 boards off each side to the right, 2 directly out the back, which are that rod and that rod. And then the other 2 rods on this left-hand side here are board rods, and they're in green. And so you've got different color boards for each side, just to show you which side to put it out on, basically, is the only thing that does. And you just want to be pulling your speed from 0.5 to 0.7, maybe a little less, maybe a little more. It just depends on what they want. We'll experiment with it. But 0.5 to 0.7 seems to be the magic number for the old catfish dragging and vertical drifting. When they're back in here shallow, they are active. So sometimes you can go a little faster than you could main channel stuff, vertical drifting. Because if they're back in here, they're feeding. There's no other reason for them to be back here.
So this is side scan imaging. It's scanning out to the left and right of the boat and just tons and tons and tons of big gizzard shad. Whenever you've got differentiation in the school, those are big gizzard shad. The threadfin shad, the smaller ones that are like that big, will just look like a mist. These are big gizzard shad. And then there's a couple of bigger fish over off here to the left, but these are big schools of gizzards. And that's what those catfish are in here feeding on. Not 2 seconds after our little thing explaining how to do it, Brad's hooked up on a planer board fish. Oh, he came unhooked too.
Did he?
Dang. Yep. Well, that was 1,000% a hit. Hee hee.
Oh, yeah, he broke some shit out there, didn't he?
Oh, yeah, he took it in the other line.
Yeah, he did.
That's unfortunate. Yeah. Oh, Brett's on, baby.
Got it. All right, hooked up.
Trying to get the camera set back up. Brett's on. Dragonfish, baby. Woo-woo. Easy. He's pulling the boat back. How does he feel, Brett?
A little bit.
Keep it bent. Keep it bent. Where's he at? Is it, which side of the line is he on here?
There he is.
That's a decent one.
He's on right here. All right.
Go to your right. Walk up to your right. There we go. That's a nice fish. All right, come over top of me. All right. Now let me come over top of you.
Mm-hmm. That was a good little hit. Nice fish there. Okay. Walk back. Go step back down. Slam it. That's a nice one to start out with.
Oh, yeah.
A nice blue catfish. All right, we are now getting down into the deeper water and we're starting to get bit. That's the second one, about 3 minutes. Brett was like, how am I going to know when it gets hit? And then the rod just goes down.
Yeah. You get those little pliers somewhere?
Right there.
A healthy little teenager.
Why don't you look for it?
You have to use your hands.
I'm hardcore up here.
Thank you. I think so.
Sorry, old buddy.
You may have to reel it up. Try reeling it up. Nope, there's a fish on it. I think. Well, we have to bring it in anyways. He hit it and popped that board, so now. Yeah, just reel it all the way in.
All the way?
Yeah, you can pick it up out of the holder now if you want to. Brett's unhooking one on the floor. Chica had a hit on the other one back there, and as soon as we got in that creek channel, bam, we were getting hit. It's a good sign. Ooh, buddy. All right, well, we're back in action now after almost having a double. So you can pick him up there, Brett.
Oh, come on. He's a big one.
Whew. You know how to hold them right?
No. I'm just gonna hug him. Hey, big guy.
Nice first fish there, Brett. Hold him up. Let's see him. That's a good one to start the evening with.
Oh, yeah.
He fought. He slammed it. They out here feeding.
Why does it look like that?
His whiskers? Why those are called barbels. That?
Yeah. Oh.
There we go. His slime was just.
All right, buddy.
Throw them back. See ya.
See ya.
Nice. All right, Chica, you're up.
Okay.
That one just got hit. That green board right there's board got popped. It got hit when you were turned the other way. The Hellkite rod.
Yeah.
Definitely the one on your right needs to come in. You see how it's popped and it's going back behind the boat?
This one?
Green one. Right, the one next to Brett,
yeah.
That one needs to come in. There's like three of them getting hit by dinks right now. The name of the game with this type of catfishing is covering water and picking up active fish. Like, again, if they are back in this shallow area and they've got deep water access, the only reason why they're back in here is because they are active and feeding. So you just can catch unimaginable numbers of fish. Just boom, 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 boom. And it's daggum pretty out here. Not my hair though.
And they go, but you need to change your attitude because you're really bad for the demeanor. This is one of the
cool. Yeah. Yeah.
Get it?
Oh, you got one?
Oh, yeah, maybe.
Is he still in there?
No.
All right, let go for a second. What happened there? No, he's still there, real quick. May need to bring it in anyways. He was dinking the crap out of it.
Oh.
That was a hit. That's a hit. Oh, that's a hit.
Yeah,
keep doing your
work. Yeah, get the green one. Reel down on it. Oh, there we go. Is he on there, Brett?
Yeah, I think so.
There we go. Woo! Go easy. Don't ski him, man. You got to fight him. There you go. Just keep that rod bent. There we go. Reel. Is he still there?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Look at that pretty sunset. He slammed it. Well, you're up next, I guess.
Again.
He coming at you?
So.
What we got here? What we got? Blue cat. Yeah, that's a blue cat. He slammed the heck out of it. Very nice.
Come on.
Okay. I think we had another one get hit. Yeah, just pick it up and pull him in. Whoop. That ripe rod, I think, got hit too. As I'm getting the boat repositioned after that one fish, I see a planer board skirting off to the left and diving down deep. So we're trying to turn around here and Chica's hooked up. That's a good one. All right, just ease him. That's a good fish, I think. There we go. Put that rod in your gut if you can.
Like this?
Yep. Yeah. I think you've got a decent fish. Keep that rod bent. I think you got a good fish. Making any line? Where's he at? Oh, you got a little drag there. All right, ease him up. There you go. Ease him up there. This may be a netter, Brett. Oh, he's decent, for sure. Oh, she got some drag going. Yeah! That's a good one. Heck yeah, nice. Heck yeah, that's a good one. Good fish. He slam a jammed it, didn't it?
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
I got my workout in.
He's heavy.
Oh my God.
That's a big one.
Holy shit. Sorry. Did I get to hold it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And there's a double.
It's like twice the size of mine.
Yep. That's what she said.
I wasn't expecting to be that hard.
See if we can't get us a 50 or a 60 now. That's a good one. There's some awfully pretty boots to be fishing in, Chica.
Well, they're rain boots. Those are the country. They're rain boots, so they'll be okay,
right? They're rain boots. That's some nice fish, guys. Yeah. Heck yeah. What did you think about that? What a fight.
Awesome. She's always catching bigger fish than I am.
Yep. Seems how it goes. All right, let's release that big one.
What do I do? Kind of clock him?
Yeah, he'll go right off.
He's fighting on my finger.
Yep, they do that. Ow. He gone. That one slammed it. We were trying to get turned, and then Brett's like, hey, that board's down. And it started peeling line. Okay. Next.
Really?
Yeah.
Don't get on the blind shark.
Okay.
Just
see.
Look at that finger.
Yeah.
We back in action. Finally got our 6 boards out after that flurry of fish, and now we're about to catch some more. I'm going on Snapchat too, it looks like. We gotta get us like a 50 or a 60. That would be awesome. One where you both gotta hold it. I got that toboggan here too, and I haven't eaten anything, which is not normal for me. I forgot to eat this morning. That one just got hit. Yep, that one right there.
Green one?
The, this one? He put it down. Yeah, the one right there. It just went dunk. I'm about to turn into Betty White. Where are my Snickers? Come on, fish. Where you at? Hit one of them boards. We want to see him skirting across the surface. We have moved back upstream, and now we are anchored up on a big giant rock pile behind us, and we've just got a little bit of flow. It got dark on us up there on the upper end of the lake, so we've run down to the middle section, and we got about 8 rods out, double anchored out the front and back, and we're going for a big one. That is the goal now, is just catch a giant. We got huge hand-sized baits out. And we are sitting on some good structure where I've caught a lot of big fish in the past. So we'll see.
Hold this.
That current just kicked on big time. Right when we gotta leave. What time is it?
8:10.
Chica may have one here.
Now?
Where's he at? Let's see. Is he still on it?
I don't know.
It just went down hard.
Yeah, I see.
Yeah, so step out there if you can. Be careful.
Okay.
Yeah, real. Keep going, keep going, keep going. Got him?
Yeah.
All right, get up out of there.
Well, maybe.
He's on there. Get him! Good job. You got him?
Yeah.
Here, let's see. Turn that. Is he coming?
Yeah. I don't know. Maybe not.
Yeah, he's there. All right, you can step back down. Here, let me see what you're working with here. That's just a bigger one, maybe. Little blue. You got him.
Now what?
Okay.
You hold on to that for me, bro.
I'm glad we got that on camera.
All right, step down.
That is 10 pounds or so.
Ain't that big old skipjack chunk. Right in the corner of the mouth.
All right, there's the first night fish of the evening. We missed one good one before this that will not make it into the video because many cuss words were said. However, we do have this one. You can throw them back.
Is that me?
Maybe. It got crazy dang cold there when the wind picked up again after dark. So a couple minutes after that fish, we ended up calling it because it was just plain old freezing and I was getting hangry. That being said, we had a heck of a fun time catching a bunch of fish dragging the creek channels on Watts Bar and got to enjoy that crazy beautiful sunset. Now, in the next video that's already been filmed, Lonis and I go to the complete opposite end of the lake to an area I've never fished before, and I don't know why, and we had a huge amount of success, and it was just gorgeous down there. We caught some big catfish, stripers, a little bit of everything, and it was just a heck of a fun time. So you're going to want to be sure to stay tuned for that video that's going to be dropping later this week. And if you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button and the little bell on the bottom corner of the screen here so you get notified when I do post a new video. And man, the next one's going to be fun. So stay tuned to Top Knox Fishing. Thanks for watching. Hit that like and subscribe button. I'm again your host, Mark Cooper, the dorky ginger guy. But man, we have a good time and we like to take y'all along with us. See ya.